Kids head back to school. Jackson school officials are rerouting buses to make sure they don't cross dangerous bridges. Some of the bridges are in such bad shape, the city is near closing them to traffic altogether. Now, we've been tracking dangerous bridges for years now, and we've been talking about Cedars of Lebanon since 2003. Tonight, in a Who's Accountable investigation, 16 WAPT's Joseph Pleasant went to find out when that bridge will finally get fixed.
It's rotting wood and broken support beams like that one under the Cedars of Lebanon Bridge that have city engineers saying the bridge needs to be replaced, and Jackson school officials doing everything they can to make sure that school buses don't take your kids across it.
I drive across this bridge basically daily, and I do look up under there as I, stand here on the bank, and it is pretty raggedy.
Raggedy is one way to describe this bridge on Cedars of Lebanon. Bridge inspectors call its condition critical. Wood that supports the bridge is rotten and decaying. The bridge has a sufficiency rating of 17.3. That's on a 100-point scale. Right around the corner, the Manhattan Road Bridge is worse. The bridge's pedestrian crossing is already closed. Its sufficiency rating is 14. These are just two of five bridges in Jackson restricted to vehicles weighing 6,000 pounds or less, meaning school buses, which weigh around 29,000 pounds, aren't supposed to cross them. Richard Williams is accountable for making sure the buses don't.
We inform all drivers, and we post it inside of each terminal to let them know that these are the bridges you do not across.
Williams says all bus routes are designed to avoid dangerous bridges. Sometimes that means the buses must take longer routes. Every bus driver is notified of which bridges to avoid. Since the bridges are inside Jackson City limits, the city is accountable for their maintenance and replacement.
The city will be spending on this bridge and several other bridges a good bit of money in trying to bring our bridges in compliance.
Public Works Director Thelman Boyd says a lack of funding in the past has slowed repairs on city bridges. The Cedars of Lebanon Bridge has been considered dangerous since at least 2003. But the city sold bonds to generate money that Boyd says will go to fixing these bridges. However, it will be early next year before you'll see any construction. Jackson police monitor these bridges, and if you're caught violating the weight limit, you can be given a ticket. Reporting in Jackson, Joseph Pleasant, 16 WAPT News.